shadow section. We've got to be victory show. The unmistakable shape. The Boeing B-17G Flying Fortress.
Defensive guns.
It's hard to trust.
As you can probably imagine, flying an aircraft this size in formation for that long would have been incredibly tiring. If it weren't for one thing, this is a very, very well-mannered aeroplane. It's very easy to fly in formation. All the pilots I've ever spoken to, including said it loved it. They said it was just the most comfortable, stable aircraft to fly, which meant that you could hold those tight formations for many, many hours, anything up to maybe 10, 11 hours. This aircraft, of course, has taken part in many films, including, of course, the film Memphis Belle, which was about the first B-17 in the 8th Air Force to complete its allocated 25 missions. See there that they've been passed with the bombay open. The two big doors in the centre of the fuselage, as I said. If you're going all the way to Berlin, you'd only carry 4,000 pounds of bombs, but the maximum bomb load on this aircraft is anything up to 16,000 pounds. But of course, again, it's a trade-off. Because you've got all the guns and defensive armament. If you carry more bombs, you only carry less fuel. So that limited your range with a maximum bomb load.
Oh, what have you got?
If you look just behind the Bombay doors, you can see a over here. You can see a little blister sticking out. That's the bomb turret. There was somebody actually curled up, his knees up around his ear holes, basically. Curled up inside that turret with two guns sticking out on either side of him. He was hydraulically operated. He had a pair of handles. Twist the turret through 270 degrees, 360 degrees horizontally. Made it a very effective defensive position, but it also meant that the bomb turret couldn't be pulled. In fact, when the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor began, 6th of December 1941, six of these were transferring out to the Pacific Theater, were actually in the process of landing on the airfield top of mine, right into the middle of the Japanese attack. Last pass there, thank you, Sally G. She's going to head back to her home in Duxford. Many thanks to them for bringing that aircraft to us today.